Fall evening, just right for some Friday night football. Good evening and welcome to Edmond North High School Stadium, home of the Huskies. We'd like to welcome our guests, the Mustang Broncos. We're glad that everyone got here safely. Just a quick reminder that there is a concession stand available for both sides. They both provide hot and cold beverages, hot food, and snacks for you to enjoy while you watch the game. We'd like to thank the Edmond North Football Booster Club for providing a friendly and easily available food and beverage break underneath the home bleachers. We'd also like to thank the Edmond North Band Boosters for providing the same service for our guests underneath the visitors' bleachers. Go by and say hi to the friendly staff, and thank you for supporting Edmond Public Schools. Also, please be courteous to our custodial staff and place all trash in the nearest trash can. They never get enough credit, and we need to stop and thank them for keeping our stadium looking beautiful. Let's help them out by doing our part. Weathers TV and Appliances, downtown Edmond, is a proud supporter of Edmond Athletics. Come by and check out our newly renovated showroom or shop online at weatherstv.com. Shop local and go Huskies! Ladies and gentlemen, this is a special evening of Husky football as we honor our seniors that have worked and sacrificed for 4 years. Seniors, you have represented the traditions of Edmond North with the heart of a champion. We say thank you for not only wearing our colors with honor, but also maintaining the standards that our future classes can proudly follow. Seniors, This night is for you. At this time, we would like to honor our senior football players for 2023. Shyla Sneed is our senior trainer for the football team. She is escorted by her parents, Jenny Sneed, and stepdad, Jay Shaw. Shyla plans to go to the University of Oklahoma to study sonography. Her favorite Bible verse is John 14:8. Shyla's favorite part of being a trainer has been getting to know all the girls. Ladies and gentlemen, Shyla Sneed. Number 0, Ricky Thomas, plays defensive tackle. He's escorted by his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Thomas. Ricky plans to wrestle in college and study business. His favorite quote is from Muhammad Ali, "Don't quit. Suffer now and live the rest of your life as a champion." Ricky's favorite memory was being undefeated during our freshman season. Number 0, Ricky Thomas. Number 1, Jay Slaken, plays wide receiver for the Huskies. He is escorted by his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Jay and Kayla Lakin. He plans to pursue a college football career or plans to join the United States Army after graduation in the spring. Lakin's favorite quote is from Barry Switzer. "Sometimes people around you won't understand the journey. They don't need to. It's not about them." Number 1, Jace Lakin. Dev Matthews is one of our Husky running backs, wearing the number 3 jersey. He is escorted by his parents, Mr. Dev Matthews Sr. and Mrs. Crystal Matthews. Dev plans to play college football. His favorite football memory was his first ever touchdown. Dev's favorite quote is, "You may not know now, but later you will understand." Number 3, Dev Matthews. Bryce Bender is your Husky quarterback. Number 7 is escorted by his parents, Gabe and Michelle Bender. After graduation, Bryce will be playing baseball next year for the University of Nebraska. His favorite quote is, "If you think you got it, you better get not." That's from Coach Carter Whitson. Bender's favorite memory was not just beating Memorial on our home field and celebrating with my teammates and friends, but then going to the locker room and dancing with my brothers and coaches. number 7, Price Bender. Number 12, Pearson Baker. Plays wide receiver. He is escorted by Mr. Dean Baker and Mrs. Elise Haynes. After graduation, Baker plans to attend the University of Arkansas. His favorite scripture is Philippians 4:6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. Pearson's favorite football memory was beating Memorial one last time at home. Number 12, Pearson Baker. Jordy Castillo plays linebacker for the Huskies. Number 18 is escorted by his parents, Billy and Becky Castillo. After graduation, Jordy plans to serve a 2-year mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Favorite scripture is, when ye are in the service of your fellow being, you are only in the service of your God. That's from Mosiah 2:17. Castillo's favorite memory this year was beating Memorial. Ladies and gentlemen, number 18, Jordy Castillo. Number 21, Angelo Norman plays defensive end. He is escorted by his parents, Ray and Crystal Norman. Angelo plans to attend college after graduation. His favorite scripture is Proverbs 12:23. Whoever loves discipline loves knowledge, but he who hates correction is stupid. Angelo's favorite memory from football was all the competitions we had during the summer training. Number 21, Angelo Norman. Caden Dickman, number 22, plays both cornerback and wide receiver for the Huskies. He is escorted tonight by his parents, Mr. Daniel and Mrs. Ashley Dickman, and his family. After graduation, Dickman also plans to serve a 2-year mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. After he completes his mission, he plans to attend BYU. One of his favorite quotes is, each day is a day of decisions, and decisions determine your destiny. That's from Russell M. Nelson. Caden Dickman's favorite memory is the senior dinner with his buddies. Number 22, Caden Dickman. Cade Carr, number 24, plays defensive end, tight end, and running back. Tonight he is escorted by his parents, Chris and Jennifer Carr. After graduation, Carr plans to attend the University of Oklahoma. His favorite quote is from Rocky Balboa. It ain't about how hard you hit, it's about how hard you get hit and keep moving forward. Cade's favorite memory in football goes back to his little league when he played quarterback and he pitched the ball to Dev for a touchdown. Number 24, Cade Carr. Dalton Minnick, number 32, is escorted by his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Danny and Pam Minnick. Dalton plays linebacker. His plan after graduation is to attend the University of Oklahoma and major in business. His favorite quote is from our former Husky, Colton Schneider, changing I have to I get to. We'll do a whole 180 twist on how you view things. Minnick's favorite memory was beating Santa Fe last year on the 2-point conversion. Number 32, Dalton Minnick. Cole Simone plays safety. Number 33 is escorted by his dad, Mr. Mark Simone, and his mom, Ms. Sherry Simone. He plans to attend Oklahoma State University after graduation. Cole's favorite scripture is Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will make your path straight. Number 33, Cole Simone. Number 34, Russell Rainey is one of our defensive linemen. He's escorted tonight by his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Rainey. After graduation, Rainey plans to serve on a mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. His favorite scripture comes from Doctrine and Covenants 6:36. Look unto the Lord in every thought, doubt not, fear not. Russell's favorite memory was Beatty Memorial. Number 34, Russell Rainey. Jameson McGee plays defensive end. Number 37 is with his parents, Jamie and Corey McGee. After graduation, McGee plans to become a veterinarian. His favorite quote is, "It's not the will to win that matters. It is the will to prepare to win that matters." This is from Paul Bear Bryant. Jameson's favorite memory was beating Santa Fe his junior year. Number 37, Jameson McGee. Ty Scott plays tight end and linebacker for the Huskies. He is escorted by his dad, Gregory McCardle, and his stepmother, Brittany Darty. Scott plans to work a job and find a passion he can go to college for. Ty's favorite verse is Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. Number 48's favorite memory is being able to experience an opportunity with a great team and coaching. Number 48, Ty Scott. Number 50, Landon Hawk, is our Husky center. He is escorted by his parents, Coach Jeff Hawk and Alicia Hawk, along with his brother, Brady. After graduation, Hawk plans to play college football. His favorite quote is from Michael Phelps. If you want to be the best, you have to do the things others aren't willing to do. Landon's favorite memory was when we found out we had made the playoffs for the first time in 10 years. He also would love to wish his mom a very happy birthday. Number 50, Landon Hawk. Number 64, Patrick Wood plays defensive tackle. He's escorted tonight by Mr. Aaron and Mrs. Nikki Wood. Patrick plans to study engineering, physics in college. His favorite quote is, "The past is a place of reference, not a place of residence. The past is a place of learning, not a place of living." Wood's favorite memory was being Memorial this year and celebrating with his brothers. Number 64, Patrick Wood. Mason Moose Priest is an offensive and defensive lineman. Number 72 is escorted by Mr. Joe Priest and Ms. Tammy Priest. Priest plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and study computer programming. His favorite scripture is from Ecclesiastes 9:10. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all of your might. For when you go to the grave, there's neither work, nor planning, nor knowledge, nor wisdom. Mason's favorite memory is when the offensive line went to the OU versus SMU football game together. Number 72, Mason Priest. Jesus Ramirez, number 85, is the son of Jesus and Elizabeth Ramirez. His favorite Bible verse is Deuteronomy 31:6. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, because the Lord your God goes with you, and he will never forsake you. His favorite quote is, "Dreams are not what you see in your sleep. They are things that do not let you sleep." That's from Cristiano Ronaldo. Ladies and gentlemen, number 85, Jesus Ramirez. Number 89, Brayton Turner plays tight end and outside linebacker. He is escorted tonight by Shanna Reed Aguilar, and Owen Reed Aguilar, and Bruce Turner. After high school graduation, Turner plans to play football in college and pursue an engineering degree. His favorite scripture comes from Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Turner's favorite memory was beating the Bulldogs by 30. Number 89, Brayden Turner. Davian Camacho plays nose guard, number 95, and is escorted by his mother, Mrs. Escobel, and his brother, G. Rios. After college, he plans to be as rich as possible. His favorite quote is, "I'm going to show you how great I am." Camacho's favorite memory was his last summer pride. Number 95, Fabian Camacho. Congratulations again to our senior Husky football players. Let's give them a hand. Up next is our senior cheerleaders in Palm. Serenity Brown is escorted by her parents, Jay Brown, Cynthia Brignon, and her sister, Aubrey. After graduation, Serenity plans to attend the University of Oklahoma to study nursing. Her favorite scripture is 2 Timothy 4:17, "The Lord stood with me and strengthened me." Ms. Brown's favorite memory was beating Memorial. Serenity Brown. Kaylin Edenfield is escorted by her parents, Mr. and Mrs. Edenfield. After graduation, Kaylin plans to attend college. Her favorite quote is, "Don't worry, be happy." Kaylin's favorite memory is winning states. Kaylin Edenfield. Maddie Freeburn is walking with her parents, Melissa and Josh Freeburn. After graduation, Maddie plans to attend Oklahoma State University with the plan to pursue a career in orthodontics. Her favorite Bible verse is Psalm 118:24. "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Ms. Freeburn's favorite memory will always be winning state three times with the best team and best coaches. Maddie Freeburn. Kay Harris is the daughter of Jeremy and Brooke Harris. She plans to attend college, but is not sure which college she will be attending. Her favorite scripture is 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through verse 18. "Rejoice always, pray continuously, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Jesus Christ." Kay's favorite memory is winning state her freshman, sophomore, and senior years. Kay Harris. Nehemiah Mitchell is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Mitchell. After graduation, Ms. Mitchell plans to study criminal justice at the University of Oklahoma. Her favorite Bible verse are Proverbs 3, 5-6. "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take." Nehemiah Mitchell. Lexi Morgan is escorted tonight by her parents, Mike and Carmen Morgan. Next year, Lexi plans to cheer at the University of Oklahoma and study kinesiology. Her favorite quote is, "If you never try, you'll never know." Ms. Morgan's favorite cheer memory was winning state our senior year. Lexi Morgan. Olivia Moxley is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Moxley. After graduation, she plans to attend college. Okay. Her favorite quote is, "How about dim apples?" Olivia's favorite memory was having a grand old time at OU cheer camp. Olivia Moxley. Rachel Pochesny is escorted by her parents, Mr. and Mrs. Pochesny. After graduation, Rachel plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and major in pre-dentistry. Her favorite scripture is Philippians 4:13. "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." Ms. Pajinski's favorite cheer memory is winning state our senior year and taking back our state title. Rachel Pochisney. Abby Randall is with her mom and dad, Sean and Mara Randall. She has been accepted into multiple universities and is still undecided on which school she plans to attend but she plans to pursue a career in the medical field. Her favorite quote is from Maya Angelou, who said, "People will forget what you said. People will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." Abby Randall. Emma Russell is escorted by Stephanie and Matthew Whitworth. After graduation, Ms. Russell plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and study speech pathology. Her favorite verse comes from John chapter 15, verse 12. "My command is this, love each other as I have loved you." Emma's favorite cheer memory is Wayne State with my best friends. Emma Russell. Kimber Simon is with her parents, Scott and Amy Simon. After graduation, Kimber plans on pursuing a career in cosmetology. Her favorite scripture is Isaiah 41:10. "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Ms. Simon's favorite memory was winning state with her best friend, Kimber Simon. Yesenia Weddle is escorted by her parents, Rebecca and Chad Weddle. Next year, Yesi plans to attend Oklahoma Baptist University. Her favorite quote is YOLO, and her favorite memory is winning the cheer state title our senior year. Yesenia Weddle. Our final senior cheer member is Ellie Lawler, who is accompanied by her sister, Addie Lawler. A senior member on our POM team, Ellie and Addie are escorted by their parents, Doug and Tara Lawler. After graduation, both girls plan on attending Texas Christian University. Ellie's favorite scripture is Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Ellie's favorite cheer memory is winning cheer state. Addie's favorite Bible verse is 2 Corinthians 12:9. Weakness. "So now I am glad to boast about my weakness so that the power of Christ can work through me." Addie's favorite POM memory was cheering at the Memorial football game this year and the state basketball tournament last year. Ellie and Addie Lawler. Our next senior on the POM team is Remy Bell. She is escorted by Deborah and Carrie Bell. She plans to continue to be on POM in college and will study psychology. Currently, she is deciding between Arizona State University or the University of Arkansas. Her favorite scripture is John 16:33. "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world." Ms. Bell's favorite POM memory is getting ready for game day every year and the bus ride there. Remy Bell. Harper Choate is the daughter of Jeremy and Kara Choate. She plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and study to become a nurse practitioner. Harper's favorite Bible verse is Philippians 4:13. "I can do all things through him who gives me strength." Ms. Cho's favorite POM memory was performing at the game day state competition. Harper Choate. Carson Kolov is supported by her parents, Rick and Kylie Kolov. She will be attending the University of Arkansas and major in elementary education. Her favorite scripture is from Romans chapter 1, verse 16. "For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes." Carson's favorite memory was eating Chandler's engagement cookie cake. Carson Kolov. Corinne Craig is supported tonight by her mother, Cassie Craig. She plans to study cosmetology after graduation. Her favorite quote is, "Sometimes in life, you crank that sold you, boy. Other times it cranks you. Her favorite prom memory are all of the bus rides to and from the away game. Corin Craig. Emma McNeese is escorted by her mother, Kristen McNeese, and her brother, Jack. She plans to attend college after graduation. Her favorite Bible verse is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Emma's favorite memory was beating Memorial on our home field. Emma McNeese. Ryan Morris is the daughter of Doug and Julie Morris. She will also be attending the University of Arkansas and plans to study biomedical engineering. Her favorite scripture is John 16:33. I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart. I have overcome the world. Her favorite memories on the Palm team would have to be cheering for the Huskies in their victory at the state basketball championship. Ryan Morris. Cameron Sigmund is escorted by her parents, Jack and Taylor Sigmund. After graduation, Cameron wants to go either the University of Arkansas or the University of Oklahoma and study clinical psychology. Her favorite quote is from Taylor Swift. Everything you lose is a step you take. Cameron's favorite prom memory was her first varsity football game. Cameron Sigmund. Reagan Wood is the daughter of Ray and Brooke Wood. She plans to major in biomedical engineering and hopes to become a dentist. Her favorite quote, my mama always says life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. That's from Forrest Gump. Miss Wood's favorite memory is cheering the Huskies to a huge victory over Memorial at home this year. Reagan Wood. Congratulations to our senior cheer and pom team. What memories and friendships you have made that will last a lifetime. Give them a hand.
The Edmond North Band Program is proud to honor 15 seniors and their families who have contributed countless hours of time, energy, and great musical moments for our band program. Our first senior, Ryan Black. Ryan plays the oboe and has served as a drum major for the past two seasons. Ryan is accompanied by his parents, Kathy and Michael Black. After high school, Ryan plans to attend a top 25 university for electrical engineering. Grant Donovan. Grant plays the baritone and is accompanied by his parents, Lisa and Gary Donovan. After high school, Grant plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and study meteorology. Damian Glow. Damian plays trumpet and has served as a drum major for the past two seasons. Damian is accompanied by his mother, Si Kui Liu, and sisters, Lucita and Betty. After high school, Damian plans to earn a degree in chemistry and then become a high school teacher. Alora Johnson. Alora plays mellophone and is accompanied by her mother, Adri Johnson. After high school, Alora plans to take a gap year to travel in Europe while living in Belgium with family. Ben Kimbley. Ben plays French horn and serves as a drum major. Ben is accompanied by his parents, Carrie and Shannon Kimbley. After high school, Ben plans to attend the College of the Ozarks in Branson, Missouri to study business. Jacob Koff. Jacob plays snare drum on the drum line and is accompanied by his mother, Rebecca Koff. After high school, Jacob plans to attend Oklahoma State University and study aerospace engineering. Alex Laird. Alex plays the trumpet and is accompanied by his parents, Gwen and Greg Laird. After high school, Alex plans to go out of state for college and study psychology. Ryan Love. Ryan is a member of the Color Guard and is accompanied by her parents, Kari and Chris Gambrill, and her brother, Justin Love. After high school, Ryan plans to attend college and pursue a degree in animal science to become a veterinarian. Benjamin Mills. Benjamin plays tenors on the drum line and is accompanied by his parents, Jolie and Charlie Mills. After high school, Benjamin plans to attend Oklahoma State University to major in music education. Kendall Miner. Kendall plays the baritone and is accompanied by their parents, Dave and Sarah Miner. After high school, Kendall plans to attend college for mechanical engineering and later work on cars and engines. Teddy Ray. Teddy plays the trumpet and is accompanied by his parents, Buck and Suzanne Ray. After high school, Teddy plans to major in either cybersecurity or data analysis. Leland Rollins. Leland plays the bass clarinet and is accompanied by his parents, Howard and Teresa Rollins. After high school, Leland plans to study finance at Oklahoma State University. Jaden Rutledge. Jaden plays the trumpet and is accompanied by his parents, Devin and Tanika Rutledge. After high school, Jaden plans to attend Oklahoma State University to double major in zoology and music performance in order to pursue a future music profession and become a zoologist. Graham Vermillion. Graham plays tenors on the drum line and is accompanied by his father, Timothy Vermillion. After high school, Graham plans to attend Oklahoma State University to pursue a degree in chemistry. Our last senior, Sophia Yates. Sophia plays the trumpet and is accompanied by her parents, Tish and Jim Yates. After high school, Sophia plans to go to college for graphic design or a related field. Thank you, seniors, for all of your contributions to the Edmond North Band Program. Your dedication and leadership has been truly remarkable, and you will leave an incredible legacy on the Edmond North Band Program. And a special thank you to the families of these seniors for all of the support you have provided to your children and to our band family. Congratulations, Edmond North Band seniors.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove your hats for the presentation of our nation's colors by the Edmond North Junior ROTC Honor Guard. Tonight's Honor Guard includes Commander carrying the U.S. flag, Cadet Senior Airman Sophie Honeycutt, Oklahoma Flag Carrier Cadet First Lieutenant Nathan Catino, Lead Guard Cadet First Lieutenant Jason Moyes, and Rear Guard Cadet Senior Airman Cynthia Clunk. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you, Edmond North Junior ROTC Honor Guard.
does not. What? Pre-game show. Yeah. Point out the new pre-game show.
This way.
Yeah. Oh, here. Okay, so here. Okay. This thing doesn't want to go down.
Like, adjust this way?
Yeah, I'm like, just trying to point it just a little down.
Oh, so we're actually pointing at the...
Yes, yeah, that's what they're saying.
Oh,
Yeah, right.
Oh, are we standing here?
Yeah.
I thought we were pointing this way.
What's this for?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, good enough. Yeah.
There, too bad.
That's good. Can you move the camera? Like,
yeah, move it to this
one. Okay. Like
that? That's perfect.
Or do you want to put it here?
The captains for the Broncos, number 44, Caston Meadows.
Why is it?
Number one, Bryant Sanders. Number 60, Samuel Pritz. Number 65, Austin Reed.
To the right.
For the Huskies, right, the captain, number 7, Bryce Bender. Number 50, Landon Hoff.
Do we want to just do it over here?
Number 32, Dalton Minnick.
So right.
Number 3, Dev Matthews.
Let's just do it over here. Let's just do it over here.
Okay. There's not... There's... Okay.
Come on. Let's just do it over here. It's not level. Yeah, it's
like... The one that's off and deferred in the second half. They'll be kicking off defending the south end zone. Tonight's game will be officiated by Mike Keane, Mark Jackson, Clay Nichols, Tim Boyle, and Caleb
Wilson. We'll just do one at halftime.
Yeah, we'll do one at halftime. Let's just scrap this.
Okay, so we need this now.
And now, making it EYFA game ball.
Hello and welcome to Husky Network. My name is Caden Rieger here, along with co-commentator Devin Thompson. Per usual, we're here for your senior night matchup. It's the Edmond North Huskies taking on the Broncos of Mustang. Dev, how do you see this one going?
Well, I'm looking to see whether North can continue their great rushing attack that they brought last week against UConn. On the road at UConn, Dev Matthews, 303 rushing yards on 32 attempts and another six touchdowns. His second six-touchdown game on the year, the other one coming, of course, against Memorial. So I'm looking to see how they continue that rushing attack. And RB2 Cal Reeder is also no slouch. 12 carries, 71 yards last game.
Yeah, Dev Matthews tying his season high four touchdowns in a single game, but also tying the school record. We'll see if we can go and grab seven to try and break it for the second time this season. Dev Matthews clearly the centerpiece of this offense, but not only that, they do have the arm of Price Bender with some pretty good receivers downfield.
Yeah, absolutely. And not only did Dev Matthews tie the school record, but his own school record that he set against Memorial. So, as you said, it's no surprise and no secret that he is a centerpiece of this Huskies offense.
The Huskies are set to kick off here as they get ready to set to kick off. Huskies coming off a 49-34 win against UConn, which very well could have placed them in the playoffs here. And if they happen to win both this game and the next game, then you could very well see a home playoff game for your Huskies.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know the exact day, but it has been a while since the Huskies have had a home playoff game. In fact, last year, not counting the COVID year, was the first time that the Huskies have even made the playoffs since 2012.
You're right, and Reese McManus sends the kick and is fielded at about the 13-yard line. They bring up that he's got some room, but a tackle finally made, but not until he's got to about the 35-yard line. So that's how this game starts. The Mustang offense comes onto the field, and Mustang has a very capable offense. They don't have just a rushing attack, but they also have the passing attack, which makes a very dual threat, so the Huskies are going to have to be on their toes.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. However, last week against Norman, Mustang was only held to 186 yards of offense. So if they can come out with that same amount of performance, then the Huskies defense has proven that they can hold their defense, the offense is short.
Mustang is coming off a 27-19 loss to Norman on a four-game losing streak. They hand it off. He's got some room. Finally brought down. A flag is in on the play.
Looks like we're going to see a hold on the first play.
Quarterback Kogan hands
looks like
off
number 62 on Mustang.
Flag on the field.
And this Huskies defense has played pretty well to start this season.
Yeah.
Or throughout the season.
Yeah, and Caden, another thing that we've mentioned in our previous broadcasts that's killed the Huskies has just been penalties.
Holding
and careless
call against the Broncos.
At that.
This one not against the Huskies, though. This is a holding on the Broncos. That'll set up a 1st-and-20 from close to the 25-yard line.
Yeah, but as I was saying, Caden, the only thing that's really hurt the Huskies defense tremendously is the penalties, the careless penalties, you know, roughing the passer, the personal fouls, the unsportsmanlike conducts. They have killed the Huskies' momentum every single time.
1st-and-20, they look to pass, rolls out to his left. He's going to look and fire. He's got the catch, and he'll get about 10 yards on the play back to the original line of scrimmage to set up a second and
Bogart's pass is complete.
It'll be a second and long. Cold night here at Husky Stadium.
On the coverage.
Temperatures are lowest they've been all season for a game. We'll see how this can affect the game.
Yeah, definitely look forward to affect the game.
And a handoff. He's got some room. He's got some more room. He's going to take it to the 40, 30. Husky trying to chase him down. He goes diving for the end zone. And he gets in. Touchdown Mustang on the third play of the game.
I don't know about that. It looked like he may have stepped out inside the five.
Resulting in a touchdown for the Broncos.
It looks like they are going to keep it as it stands, though.
So the field goal unit is out. Huskies' offense is going to have to come out and try to make some plays to try and match that so they can get some momentum on their side.
Yeah, that's another thing that's definitely killed the Huskies' offense. They have been able to limit the small plays very well. You know, their 5-6 yard plays, they've done good at eliminating that and keeping those.
Jordan gets the point, is good.
But the big play has just killed them.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Dev Matthews is back in this game. He was not here for the last home game against Owosso, and you can see that clearly made an impact. Thus, he did play very well in the first half, but just kind of lost all that fire in the second half. And that's something that we've talked about in previous broadcasts. Is the Huskies have looked incredible during the first half, like most games. But when it comes to the second half, it's just been like a flatline.
Absolutely. And as you said, we've talked about that multiple times. And it's really been the story of the season so far for the Huskies. They have played like they belong in the playoffs. Like they're like an undefeated team in the first half. But in the second half, they come out and they just cannot find it.
Mustang getting ready to kick it off after that long touchdown. Score is 7-0 Broncos. Huskies trying to find a home playoff game. If they win one of their last two games against either Mustang or Union, and Norman loses both of their last two games, the Huskies will have home playoffs. Or if the Huskies win both their games.
Absolutely. 7-0 Broncos, only 38 seconds into the first quarter.
Here's the kick, and it's a deep one. Does have the wind carrying with it. And it'll go through the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the Huskies offense, like we said earlier, run primarily by running back Dev Matthews, who had over 300 yards on the ground in his last game and 6 touchdowns. So we'll see how much of an impact he can have here.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. But another thing that we cannot sleep on is the arm of Bryce Bender, because he had a very limited amount of passes, only 10 passing attempts last game against UConn, but on that still had 85 yards and a touchdown.
Bryce Bender in the shotgun. Dev Matthews to his right, takes a snap, hands it off, tries to make a hole, but does not get anything but a gain of about 1.5. Now set up a 2nd and 9.
Not a great sign for what's to come from the Huskies so far. Let's hope that one was a fluke.
Pick up 1. It'll be 2nd and 9.
Bender back in the shotgun. Tries the hard count. Doesn't get a draw offsides. Looks over to Coach Woodson to reset the play. 8 seconds on the play clock. Bryce Bender makes a call. Dev Matthews moves to his right. 2 seconds. Takes the snap. Finally, they do another handoff. Dev Matthews trying to make some more room, but Mustang's defense was right there and only gains about 1 on the play to set up a 3rd and 7.
Matthews, number 3, off tackle. Brought down by number 8, Johnson. 2-yard gain, we'll call it 3rd and 7.
I'm expecting that they go to the air here. Bryce Bender turns the hard count again, doesn't get them to draw off sides, and we'll look back to Coach Woodson to try and reset the play again.
Bender audibles.
Back in the shotgun. He's going to look to pass, rolls out to his right. Wide open for a first down. Tried to get the pass into Caden Dickman, but he does not make the catch. That sets up a 4th and 1. Huskies are going to have to punt it back to the Mustangs.
Yeah, an interesting move. As you said, he had Pearson Baker wide open on that right side for what looked like an easy first down. Perhaps he saw something that we didn't see, but instead he tries to fit it into to Caden Dickman.
Caden Dickman has had a big season, so you can see why that would be his primary target. But whenever you've got somebody that wide open,
that's absolutely right.
So Mustang had nobody back to receive the kick, and they're just going to let the ball roll down to inside.
Bender's punt will be down at the
32-yard line. It'll be down at about the 32. So the Huskies defense is going to come back out, hope for a better result than last time after giving up a touchdown on the third play.
Yeah, definitely not what you want to see on your first offensive possession right after you give up a big play touchdown to Mustang. As the Huskies go 3-and-out on their first drive, and back comes the defense after a good punt from Bryce Bender. Mustang will start at the 32. Sign QB run, something that has hurt the Huskies.
They finally bring him down, but he gained a solid 6 yards on that play.
Number 7, Bogai, holds his own number.
Now bring up 2nd and 4.
27, Brett on the tackle. Game of 6, 2nd and 4.
Alone in the shotgun is the quarterback. He calls the receiver to go to his right side.
Yeah, he's by himself in the backfield.
Takes a snap, but do another design QB run. And a great tackle as they finally bring him down to set up a second for a third down, but not after he's gained 2 yards.
It'll be third and two.
Bogai on the keeper, tackled by R.L. Young.
Great tackle by R.L. Young. Good to see him back in the lineup.
Touchdown!
Alone in the shotgun again. They've only got one man on that left side. They do a couple shifts. Takes a snap. They're going to do another design QB run. And they try to stuff him. He goes diving for it.
He's fumbled.
And he fumbled, and it's recovered by the Huskies. But the refs are calling him down. And Coach Woodson is not happy with the call. And they move the chains. It's a first down for the Broncos. He lost the ball, but the refs called him down. That's not good for the Huskies.
Not only did the refs call him down by contact on the fumble, it looked like he was still in the air trying to reach for a first down.
They hand it off again, and he's immediately brought down. Great job by the Husky defensive line, as it's a gain of nothing and bring up a 2nd and 10.
Yeah, great stop by Preston McDaniels there, coming down from his safety spot to lay the boom.
No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd and 10.
Takes a snap, play action.
It's the first pass.
Looks for the pass, and he's got a man, breaks a tackle. And Reese McManus is going to try and make the tackle. Finally pulls him out of bounds at the 30-yard line. That's a first down for the Broncos.
And if you heard the crowd, they were not happy with that call down by contact as he was reaching for the first down there.
We'll move the chain.
Takes a snap. They're going to hand this one off. And the Husky defense is right there. But he did gain a couple on the play.
Sanders on the carry.
Looking for 3 yards to set up 2nd and 7.
Number 22, Caden Dickman, was actually pulled after that play, as we saw him miss the tackle but allowed the first down. Hopefully we get to see him back. He's had a great year at corner.
This Mustang offense is just rolling against the Husky defense. It's 2nd and 7. They do another design QB run. They finally bring him down to bring up a 3rd and 4.
Somebody's name who we've been calling a lot and seeing a lot of so far in this game has been number 17, freshman linebacker R.L. Young. We saw him go down a couple of weeks ago with what looked like a scary injury, and it's great to see him back in the lineup, not only, but also making a huge impact here. We'll look for him to be a force on this Huskies team for years to come.
And it's 3rd down. Takes a snap. They're going to hand it off, and the Huskies defense, he's trying to push for it, and the Huskies defense brings him down. It'll be 4th down. A gain of 0. That sets up 4th and 4, and it looks like they're going to send on the field goal unit.
Tackle on the play by number 2, Ty Watts.
Great tackle by Ty Watts there. He's had a rough go of it this season, but he has proved over and over again why he deserves the spot that he has. And once again, showing it there. Strong tackle.
So a 43-yard field goal. It goes up. It looks like it went left.
It is going to be
and
wide
it went,
left.
Went wide left for no good. And the Huskies will take over back at the 33.
So it remains a one-score game. The Huskies will take over.
It looks like they're going to move them to the 20-yard line. Excuse me.
It does look as though they are going to move them to the 20-yard line. much discussing where they should move it to.
They're actually asking Coach Whitson which side that they wanted the ball to be placed on. Right or left side. They go up the left side, and the Husky offense comes back out after a big stop by the Husky defense. We'll see if it's good enough for the enough momentum for the Huskies to get a touchdown here and tie the game. Bender hands it off to Dev Matthews again, and Mustang has just been clearly ready for him, and they finally bring him down after the offensive line were trying to push the pile, and he'll gain 3 on the play to set up a 2nd and 7.
Yeah, and that's definitely something that Mustang went over all week in practice. As we've said, he's had multiple 6 touchdown games, so it's not a shock that they come into this game very prepared to see a lot from Dev Matthews. As we mentioned, over 30 carries last week against UConn, 300 yards, 6 touchdowns. So they know that he's a huge part of this offense, so they know if they can shut him down, then they can win this game very easily.
Bender moves Brayden Turner to the other side. The handoff to Dev Matthews, who looks like he's got some room, but tripped up after he gained 2 yards. That'll be a 3rd and 5 after 2 runs by the Husky offense. If they go back to the air here, we hope that Bryce Bender sees the open receiver, if there is one again. He's trying to feed it into Cade Dickman last week.
Absolutely. And on 3rd and about 5, I'm not going to be shocked if we get to see
it'll be 3rd and 5.
Another pass attempt from Bryce Bender. He's got a good arm. Committed to the University of Nebraska to play baseball.
They do a design option and a nice catch by Dev Matthews, who's going to get enough for the first down. That's a move the chains. 1st and 10 for the Huskies.
Yeah, great catch to reach out behind him and bring that one in with one hand. On the triple option.
That'll move the chains. 1st and 10, Huskies.
We'll get enough for the first down. They'll mark him down at the 31. 32, excuse me. In the backfield to his left.
Bryce Bender takes a snap. They'll do another handoff to Dev Matthews, who tries to dive for as many yards as he can, and it looks like that they'll give him Matthews about 5 on the play to set up a 2nd and 5.
Yeah, he dove trying to get, looked like about 7 or 8 yards out of it. But then, as you mentioned, they do mark him down.
Unless he's going to no huddle, go again to Dev Matthews, and he goes diving for more yards, and they're going to give him the first down. Then, so that will move the chains. It is a 1st and 10 for the Huskies. Dev Matthews, 2 great runs.
And they go hurry up again. They're going to run the same triple stack play.
And a flag on the play, and they're going to call a false start on the Huskies.
That'll bring up 1st and 15.
Dead ball false start is called against the Huskies. It'll be a 5-yard penalty. Still 1st down.
They'll give him to the 38-yard line. So the Huskies still have yet to cross into Bronco territory in this game. Their second possession of the game, first one ending in a 3-and-out. This one they've been rolling a little bit better.
In this first quarter, already 3.5 minutes to go. It's been a quick first quarter here.
Yeah, and the Huskies are lucky to escape this one only 7 points down. They gave up the big play in the first drive on the 3rd play of the game. And then their last drive, they really came in, forced the field goal attempt, and shut down that field goal attempt as well to keep this a 1-score game.
Yeah, and Dev Matthews took that run for about 2 yards to set up a 2nd and 13. It's 2nd and long for the Huskies after the false start. And we'll see if they can come back from this one.
Yeah, because it's a 2nd and long, they want to try to get as many yards as they can, make that 3rd down attempt easier. I won't be shocked to see a pass here.
And the Huskies, Price Bender throws it, juggled by Brayden Turner, but still brought in. Moves it back past the original line of scrimmage to set up 3rd and 8. And we'll see if the Huskies go back to the air here to try to get another 1st down.
Yeah, great catch by Brayden Turner, and also a great job to hold on to that. As you mentioned, juggling that one in the air as he was hit. A great job to hold on to that one. And the hard count gets him.
The hard count gets him. It'll be offsides, and that moves the Huskies 5 yards forward. and a really good hard count from Bryce Bender. We've seen that has really improved a lot over the past couple weeks.
Yeah, absolutely. His hard count coming into the season, you could already tell that it had improved. But in practice, we've witnessed them continue to work on his hard count, and it has paid off as more and more every week we see him draw the offsides penalties.
And it's only 3rd and 3, two wide receivers out. He's got two running backs to his left and right, and one behind him. It's a handoff to Dev Matthews, who breaks a hole, and gets more than he needed for the first down. Moves the ball into Bronco territory, all the way down to the 36-yard line.
Good enough for another
one thing that I'm noticing with that Broncos defense, it's starting to hurt them, it looks like, is when Dev Matthews gets the ball, it looks like the safeties are trying to punch the ball out. I understand that that is what they are taught. However, with as powerful a runner as Dev Matthews is, number one priority is bringing him down. He has the best grip strength that I have seen, and he will not let go of the ball. I don't believe he's actually fumbled this year, and he showed that off.
It's a handoff to Cal Reeder, who makes a truck, gains 7 yards on the play.
Yeah, as we mentioned early in the game, RB2 and number 10, Cal Reeder, he has been very, very solid option at running back, as he has very similar running style to Dev Matthews. And we hope to see him as the starter next year on this Husky offense.
Hands off to Dev Matthews. Breaks the tackle. He's got some room. Tries to follow his blocker, but finally gets brought down, but not after he's got the first down. Gets it all the way to the 24-yard line. And the Huskies are moving towards that red zone.
Puts the ball down to the 24-yard line. That'll move the chains for the Huskies.
1 minute to go in this first quarter. Huskies trying to get some points on the board before it ends. Broncos lead 7-0. Bender takes a snap, hands it off to Dev Matthews, who somehow made it past, and finally they bring him down at the 20-yard line, so put that in the red zone. What a run by Dev Matthews. Ran into a wall and managed to get himself around it.
Yeah, great vision by him there. As you mentioned, he runs into a brick wall on that defensive line for the Broncos. Bounces out, hits the left or the right side, excuse me. And he runs for, what is that, about 5 yards? Four, and they call it four.
2nd and 4 from the 20-yard line. Bender in the back. They're going to do a quick screen pass to Dev Matthews, who's got some room. It'll be 3rd and 1 at the 15.
Bender's pass is complete to number 3, Dev Matthews.
Third down and one as the clock strikes 0 for the first quarter.
And that's the end of the first quarter.
So that ends the first quarter. Broncos up 7-0. Huskies are driving to the 15-yard line of Broncos territory. We'll see if they can pull one on the board when we come back.
We'd like to thank the following sponsors as touchdown and championship level sponsors: Insured Aircraft Title Service, Pitcher's Lawn Management, and Moxie Pest Control. Thank you. Thank you. second quarter. It'll be third and one for North.
So we come back from that break from the first quarter, and it is still 7-0, but the Huskies are driving. It is third and one at the 15 in Bronco territory.
Look to see a run from Dev Matthews to just punch it up the middle.
And that's what they do, but he's got more than 1 yard. Gets all the way down to the 3-yard line. I thought he was going to get to the end zone, but Mustang defender.
You're
going to
give him an extra yard. Mark him down at about the 2, 2.5.
Matthews gets up at the 2-yard line.
I'm calling down at the 2.
It'll be first and goal.
They're going to go hurry up. Look to see the same play.
And a flag and a false start.
False start for
Braden
Hester.
Will be called on the Huskies.
Or for Braden Turner, excuse me.
Dead ball, false start. Goes against the Huskies. Will be a 5-yard penalty. Ball will be moved back to the 7. Still, first and goal.
So the false start sets them 5 yards back to the 7-yard line.
Yeah, down by 7. They need 7 to tie it up.
This first and goal.
Both yards and points.
Bender with Dev Matthews to his left in the back. Takes a snap. They'll hand it off. Dev Matthews tries to make some room, but brought down Pat behind the 10-yard line. It'll be first
Matthews
and goal from
the
11. Right. Mustang was ready for that play.
91 Jones on the tackle.
Yeah, that brings up second and goal.
Lost on the play,
from
back
the
to 11. It'll be second down and goal.
So Huskies come back at second and goal, a false start and a loss of yards. Set the Huskies back from the 2-yard line back to the 11. They're going to look to pass here. Bender's got some room. He's going to look and try to take himself, but no, he's got Braden Turner in the background, and he is out of bounds. It'll be third and goal.
And it looks like Bender actually would have been better off just tucking it.
Bender's pass is
incomplete. It looks like he could have gotten him at least inside the 5, possibly more. That brings up third down and goal.
From the 11.
Yeah, as you mentioned, a false start and the loss of 4 on a Dev Matthews run will bring up third and goal from the 11. As Bender tried to take a shot to the end zone, even though it looked like he had a wide open running lane. A couple of key mistakes so far from Price Bender. Hopefully he can make the adjustments needed, make the corrections.
And Price
the
Bender
need this win desperately.
In the shotgun, and timeout is called by the Huskies.
The Huskies have called the timeout.
Third and goal from the 11-yard line.
The
we'll see
quarter.
What they can, what the Huskies can do when we come back.
It'll be their first timeout. Nick McDaniel, Orthopedic Therapy Services, Weather, TV and Appliance, and Balanced Kitchen. Thank you for your support.
Huskies from the 11-yard line.
It is third and 11. If you're tuning in, my name is Caden Rieger along with Dev Matthews, per usual, here on Husky Network. Dev Thompson. Excuse me. And it is Price Bender in the back. got some pressure and tripped him up, and they bring him down. And that sets up a fourth and long. And Pricewinder was not able to get out of that.
Yeah, a couple of key mistakes on that drive from Pricewinder. And hopefully he can watch the film on that, have a conversation with Coach Whitson, and come back looking like his normal self after the field goal was out.
Right, Reese McManus on field goal attempt.
So it is Reese McManus coming out for the field goal.
Looks like it's going to be a
34-yarder, and they will draw him offsides. That will bring up another. That will give the Huskies a quick 5 yards to try and make the field goal a little shorter.
Yeah, we'll see what they decide here. But like you said, probably going to be the smarter idea to just kick the field goal and get the points, although that will put them at the 12-yard line.
Still fourth down.
Broncos crowding the line.
Bruce McManus to kick it from a shorter range. Kick is up. And it goes through. It is good to put 3 points on the board. 7-3 is your score. So the Huskies come away with some points, but kind of a disappointing end to the drive. They were at the 2-yard line, but a couple of crucial mistakes.
The
Hudson and Bender looks like they're going to take a walk. Probably a good idea. Have a conversation with your coach and reset after that. As they got into the red zone, just weren't able to punch it in, even though they started from a 2 at first and goal.
Broncos, back deep, number 8, Johnson, and number 11, Everhart. McManus, number 8, kicking off for the Huskies.
It's a very cold night here. Off after getting the 3 points. A little under 10 minutes to go here in the first half. And kick is up, and it goes over his head, and it'll go back through the end zone for a touchback. And that'll start the Broncos at the 20-yard line.
The Broncos will have first and 10.
Yeah, lucky for him, that one actually bounced into the end zone. That one got over his head, got away from him. Huskies were coming, storming down the field. And that would have been a huge momentum change. So the Husky defense comes back out, allowing the big play, touchdown, third play of the game to the Broncos on their first drive. Second drive, they let up.
Takes the snap, throws for a screen, and a couple of blocks leads to an open lane, but knocked out of bounds. It is good enough for the first down for the Broncos.
Yeah, first down and a little more.
In the flat, number 19, Vaughn. Ball's on the 38-yard line, first down.
Takes a snap, hands it off. They're going to look to run, and could have gotten away with a horse collar there as he tugged the jersey to bring him down.
Yeah, so that actually wouldn't be a horse collar. The jersey is a completely legal part of the uniform tackle
the middle.
You cannot tackle from the inside of the pads.
Number 89, Brady Turner. Second down.
Takes a snap. They're looking to pass. He rolls out, looks to throw, and looked like Caden Dickman was there to make the tackle. And he will be short of the first down, brought out of bounds at the 45. That brings up a 3rd and 3. We'll see if the Huskies can make the stop.
Yeah, great job by Caden Dickman to hold him right there where he is, force him out of bounds. He did get a gain, but he could have very easily gotten a first down there. Great job to force him out, make it a 3rd and 3.
Third down.
Mustang takes a snap. They're going to hand it off. And they're going to bring him down. They're going to call him a yard short. It is fourth down. But we could see Mustang try to go for it.
Vaughn on the carry.
Yeah, they've been very aggressive, not only in this game, but as we've seen in previous games. So I would not be shocked. It looks like they're actually going to line up to go for it on fourth down.
Fourth down and one.
And they could just be trying to draw them offside. Looks over to the sideline. Still 15 seconds on the play clock. And a timeout will be called by Mustang as they're going to try to reset here. They still could go for it. And we'll be back in a moment. Like Mustang is going to send their offense back on the field to go for it here on fourth and one. We'll see if the Huskies can make the stop here. He is alone in the back, takes a snap. It's a design QB run, and he will get enough for the first down and more, crossing into Husky territory before the pile finally pushes it back. But he does gain three on the play, good enough for a first down. Again, if you're just tuning in, my name is Caden Rieger along with Devin Thompson. We're here on Husky Network. This could be potentially our last game of the season, calling it. Mustang takes a snap. He's going to look deep. He throws it short on the curl route and finally push out of bounds.
Not sure if they're going to give him that first down. It looks like he's going to be right on the marker.
And they are going to call him a yard short. That is second and one. I would expect from what we've seen in the past, it could most definitely be a design QB run here from Mustang.
Yeah, absolutely. It looks like they're trying to pull a page from Philadelphia's book and just go with a little bit of a design quarterback.
And the snap is fumbled, and it is finally, they call him down. He lost the hold of the ball, and that's going to lose them a couple yards. Brings up third and five.
Yeah,
so they lose 4 yards.
Yeah, some confusion in the backfield. It looks like they were trying to do that because design QB run, and it looks like the play action, excuse me, just got a little bit confused. Running back thought that he was taking it. QB tried to pull it. Just fell in between the two.
Third and five. Takes a snap to doing a screen pass. He's got some running room, and he will get the first down by 2 yards. Excuse me, 3 yards. And it is a first down for the Broncos. On the screen pass.
It looks as though they might actually call him short. No, they will give him the first.
So Mustang's offense has been rolling against the Huskies all night. In the shotgun, running back to his right.
Yeah, the last
takes the snap, looks to throw, does, but immediately brought down. A good open field tackle by Reese McManus, and they gain nothing. In his second and 10, you could just see Reese McManus flying down that field to bring him down.
Yeah, he read that in a textbook tackle as he jumps up to get the screen. He lays the boom down on him.
No gain. Second and 10.
Great tackle by Reese McManus. He has been a huge asset to this team, not only serving as the kicker, but also serving as a starting safety. And a good one at that.
Looking to pass again. Does. He's got a man open deep, and it does go out of bounds. He did not get enough on it. And some extra shoving.
Whoa!
And they bring him down, but no flag is thrown.
No flag thrown for that.
And Coach Woodson unhappy about that, as there was a lot of extra pushing and shoving.
Yeah, on multiple games, it seems like multiple times the Huskies have been more or less screwed over by no calls. I mean, against the Owosso, we had multiple times where players were thrown out of bounds, shoved down the lane, and we only had one called all game. We had multiple of it on both sides, but only one called all game, and that was against Caden Dickman.
And it is third down. In the shotgun, takes a snap, hands it off. He's got some room. He's going to try and push for it. Doesn't get it. Only gains 5 yards. It is fourth and five.
Looks like Whitson, Coach Whitson on the sideline. Still chirping at the referee. Nobody on that Husky sideline or in the Husky crowd.
And so the Bronco offense is going to stay on the field here. Takes a snap, looking to pass. Throws outside, and he has a man who catches it. Tries to make a juke move, but pushed out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
So the Broncos are going to be in the red zone. Their last red zone trip, they were held short to a field goal attempt, which was missed.
So,
we're looking to see the Husky defense hopefully hold strong, pulling out.
Throws it. He's got a man who tries to make the move and gets into the end zone. It's a touchdown for the Broncos. 13-3 is now your score as we await the PAT from the Broncos.
Number two, Hayes, is good for a Bronco touchdown.
Now, it looks like number 23, or 27, excuse me. I believe that's Matthew Kearse.
Number 39, Jordan on to the
slowed down
point
on the tackle and led to the score.
So here comes the PAT. And it almost blocked, but it is up and good to make it 14-3. 6 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the first half. Huskies need to get a touchdown here to try and get some momentum back on their side.
Yeah, and unfortunately the biggest problem for the Huskies defense hasn't even been that the Broncos offense has been more or less overwhelming. The Broncos offense has just gotten a little bit, almost lucky with the defensive breakdowns from the Huskies. I mean, we've seen multiple people drop out of coverage to go find a different coverage to drop into, and it leaves somebody wide open for a big play.
So the Huskies are going to be able to come back and getting ready to receive the kickoff here. So Mustang getting ready to set up for the kickoff.
Number 10, Cal Reader, number 23. Tatum Willis back deep for the Huskies.
Tatum Willis and Cal Reader are going to be back deep.
Kicking against the wind here.
Yeah, we'll look to see how that affects them as this is their first kickoff going into the wind instead of going with it. Perhaps
Huskies need some momentum here.
Perhaps we see our first Husky return here. As you mentioned, going against the wind.
And the kick is off. It is up. Wind starts pushing it. Muffed by Tatum Willis, but he picks it up and is immediately brought down. And they're saying it is fumbled and recovered by Mustang.
The refs, I believe they called him down by contact.
And they're going to discuss it for a second. Mustang thinks it's theirs. And they give it to Mustang. Mustang will take over at the 20-yard line after Tatum Willis muffed the punt, picked it up, and then fumbled it. And Coach Whitson is not happy with the call here.
Coach Whitson is demanding an explanation. It did look like he was down by contact, especially after we had another play earlier in the game where the quarterback was called down by contact as he reached over the line and the ball was knocked out of his hand. Un- Whitson, I do agree with him that the call was wrong. However, he does need to go back to his sideline before he costs the Huskies even more yards.
So Mustang takes over at the 20-yard line. They take the snap, look to pass. Has a wide-open man on the side. That's not Reese McManus. And he's trying to make some room. Travels to the other side. And finally brought down. But not until he's got the first down at the 7-yard line.
One thing that I'm noticing is on this line, we've seen multiple almost blindside and late hits coming from that offensive line of the Broncos. A little bit of pushing and shoving after the play, a little bit of cheap shots, but none of them called yet.
So they hand it off. He tries to dive for the end zone, doesn't get it. That brings up second and two. Second and goal from the 2-yard line.
Looks like this will lead to a Husky score. Or
Broncos score. Coming down by number zero, Ricky Thomas.
Husky's crowding the line, hoping to prevent that.
They will hand it off. He's got some room, but gets taken down at the 1-yard line. Brings up third and one. The Huskies trying to make a goal line stand. Still have two downs to go.
Yeah, and if they can make a goal line stop here, that would be huge, keeping this a two-possession game.
Tackle by number 17, R.L. Young.
And once again, R.L. Young making a name for himself as just a freshman.
And a flag is called, and they're calling offside on the defense. That'll be half the distance to the goal, along with a replay of third down.
We'll see the Huskies crowd the line, hope to prevent the rushing touchdown. Wanting to make him get it through the air.
So at the 1-yard line, it is third down. Some adjustments.
Watch for the design QB run to that left side.
And that is what they do, and he will fight for it, and they call him in for the touchdown. I did not think that he made it there, but they give it to him anyway.
Even after it was whistled dead, he was eventually into the end zone, so it would not have mattered anyways.
That will be a touchdown for the Broncos. That brings the score 20-3, awaiting the PAT. The Huskies starting to lose grip on this game.
Yeah, and they need to make a huge statement on offense before the end of the half. They need to score at least once. If they can make a huge defensive stop and score twice, that would be ideal.
And the kick is up and good.
However, it would take a miracle for them to tie it up or even take the lead before we hit halftime.
21, Edmond North 3.
And hopefully what we get to see from the Huskies is the halves are actually reversed this time. As this has been the slowest first half that we have seen from the Huskies all season. And normally they have done a fantastic in the first half, come out in the second half a little bit lackluster. But it looks like they actually have come out in the first half a little bit lackluster this time. Perhaps riding a little bit too high from that win against UConn.
So it does bring the score 21-3. So Mustang comes back out to kick it off.
And it'll be a three-score game with 5:02 left to go in
number
the half.
Cal Reader. And number 23, Tatum Willis, back deep for the Huskies.
And so they do bring Tatum Willis back out to try again on this kickoff. He was the one who muffed it and fumbled last time.
Yeah, he was, but he has been a really reliable returner. In fact, the first fumble that he has not only lost, but also lost possession of. First fumble that's been forced against him and the first fumble that's been recovered by the opposing team, I should say.
And here's the kickoff. It's short. Fielded at the 30-yard line and muffed again, and it is recovered by Mustang, and the Huskies will not be on offense for the third straight drive.
Wow. Twice in a row we see a muffed punt from the Huskies special teams. And the special teams has been a huge part of their lackluster play in the second half. As we've seen multiple times, they've gotten a little bit too comfortable with their leads. They've lost punts. They've lost kickoff returns. They've given up way too many yards to start a drive. And here we see the special team struggles yet again as we see two muff kick returns in a row.
They look to pass. He's going to throw deep. He's got a man, and it will be a touchdown for the Broncos. They get in again on the first play of that drive.
Number 15.
It took 12 seconds for the Huskies to give up a touchdown, lose the ball, and give up a second touchdown. As the score is now 27-3, the Huskies are starting to lose control of this game very quickly. It took only 12 seconds for this to go from a 14-0 game to a 14-3 game, excuse me, to a 27-3 game, awaiting the extra point to make it 28-3.
And Braden Turner tries to snap the
dead ball
kick.
Penalty offside against Edmond North.
And they'll be offside. And that'll move the ball closer to the field goal.
PAT attempt
is up.
Good.
And it is good. And that makes it 28-3 is the score. The Broncos do lead. It's going to take a lot from the Huskies if they want to try and win this game.
And your Huskies 3.
It's going to take a lot for them to come back now as we have a four-score game. This is not looking good for the Huskies. Hopefully they can come out of the locker room at the half with a fire under them. Not only that, but also put together a good drive here to put up some points. Possibly help them out. As here comes the special teams unit. We were talking about earlier, I've had many struggles throughout the season, and those struggles continue to show throughout this game as we've had two muff punts in a row leading a drive starting in Husky territory.
So instead of Tatum Willis this time, it's Dev Matthews out deep with Cal Reeder. And so three straight drives, and it's been Mustang on all three of them. Husky offense has not been on the field for a while.
Yeah, the Husky offense has not been on the field since very early in the second quarter. In fact, that drive capped off with a Reese McManus field goal was the last time that the Husky offense has seen the field.
And so they do another high kick, and this time it is caught. They do a fair catch to avoid any fumbles, and so the Huskies offense is finally able to come back on.
He gets a high five from Coach Whitson for actually catching it. And the Husky offense will come back on the field for the first time since the Reese McManus field goal very early in the second quarter.
This is the mark of the ball at the 34-yard line. Moving first in hand, Husky.
So here comes this Husky offense. Bryce Bender in the shotgun, Deb Matthews to his right. They're going to look to pass here. And they gets it to Jace Lakin, who gets pushed out of bounds.
Bender's pass is complete.
Gets it to the 40-yard line to bring up, all the way down to the 39 to set up a second and three.
Looks like number 28 on the Broncos being barked at by that north sideline.
Who's got a back on number 28, Bacchus? 6-yard gain, second and four.
Lines up across from Jace Lakin again.
So the handoff to Deb Matthews this time. He tries to get some room, just goes right into the brick wall. That'll be third and one.
Look to see another run from Deb Matthews here. He just tried to punch it over that first down line.
Number 91, Jones. It'll be 31.
And they hand it off again and fumbled. by Dev Matthews and recovered. And that's what the fourth turnover by the Huskies.
This game is getting out of hand fast.
And that sets up the Mustang offense in Husky territory again at the 35.
Yeah, the third straight time that the Huskies have set up the Broncos in their territory. Looks like we see a penalty against the Broncos.
Broncos will have it first and 10 on the Husky 40-yard line.
See a penalty flag, not sure what was called or if anything was called. The Broncos will start from the Husky 40. For the third straight drive in a row, they will start in Husky territory, up 28-3.
Takes a snap, they're gonna hand it off. And he's got some room, he's got some more room. Finally brought down, but there is a flag thrown way back.
This one may be coming back. This one will be coming back. It will be hands to the face.
Holding is the call against the Broncos.
Holding, excuse me. On the Broncos, this one will come back.
That'll bring up a first and 20 for the Broncos.
Repeat first down.
And that moves them back into their own territory, back at the 50-yard line.
Moving back into neutral, actually, right at the 50. Half of a field to go if the Broncos want to extend this lead. It'll take one heck of a comeback to make this a close game at half.
So looking to pass, another curl route and is caught again and finally thrown down. But the forward progress will get him to the 40-yard line instead of second and 10, a 10-yard gain.
Yeah, it'll set him right back up. They'll gain that penalty right back.
So they take the snap. Looks to throw, almost sacked. Still chasing him down. Finally pushed down, but the throw is caught. Moves him inside the red zone. And Mustang continue to roll.
Pogar's pass is complete to number 15. Johnson. Down to the 19-yard line, it'll be first and 10.
Takes a snap, hands it off. Running back's got some room. Finally brought down, but not after he's gained.
Sanders on the carry.
About 5 yards.
Number 44, Jace Whitefield on the tackle.
It will be second and 5.
Ball from the 15, second down.
Looks to hand it off and dodges a tackle, but gets brought down for no gain. It is third
Sanders
down.
Sanders on the carry. Back on the play by number 24, Kate Bard.
In a cold night here at Husky Stadium.
Our game, third and 5.
In the shotgun, running back to his left. It is third down and 5. Some motion. And looking to throw, does, has the catch, breaks a tackle, walks into the end zone, and it is another touchdown for the Broncos, extending their lead.
Johnson on the reception for a Bronco touchdown.
And this game got out of hand extremely fast. As we saw at the start of this quarter,
the score was only 7-0 at the start of this quarter, and they've run it up all the way to if the PAT is good, it'll be a score of 35-3.
Absolutely. Yeah, hard to imagine that in one quarter it went from a 4-point game, as it stands, a 31-point game, 32-point game.
The field goal is no good. He goes wide left. PAT's no good, which makes a score of 34-3. It is
still a 31-point
game. It is a 31-point game. We'll see if the Huskies can try to get on the board here before halftime. They do receive, so if they could get a touchdown, come back out from halftime, get another touchdown, that could be very crucial for this game.
Absolutely. They need to strike fast, though, because if they cannot get something in before the half, then this might just be over. This might be over before the second half even gets started. And I truly believe that if the Huskies cannot get something going in this drive, if they can't punch it in for a touchdown, at least make this a 24-point game, then they will not have a chance of winning this game coming out in the second half, even if they receive it.
So a lot of struggles here from the Husky offense.
Yeah, and a lot of those struggles actually showing from the special teams unit, as we saw two muffed kickoff returns go the Broncos' way, and then a Dev Matthews fumble on their first possession since the field goal. So second quarter possessions, excuse me, for the Huskies. Field goal and then three lost fumbles in a row. Not an ideal start.
So Mustang set to kick it off again. And the kick is up. It's another high kick and a fair catch call made by Jace Lakin at about the 26-yard line. So that's where the Huskies offense will start. We'll see if they can get something done here. 2 minutes to go in this game.
The Huskies will set up shop on the 25-yard line. It'll be first and 10.
So Huskies set up shop at the 25. It is Bender in the shotgun with Dev Matthews to his left, who fumbled on the last drive. And a delayed handoff makes a move, tries to cut through another hole, but is brought down at the 30-yard line. That'll bring up second and 5.
Number 3, Dev Matthews, goes off tackle. Brought down by number 10, Stevens. 5-yard gain, second and 5.
So we have an injured Husky.
Official timeout on the field.
And we'll be back in a moment.
Looks like that's number 50, Landon Hawk.
Husky needed help as he came off, and they will bring him over to the medical bench. And the Huskies set up at about the 30-yard line, where it is second and 5. Price Bender is in the shotgun.
It's number 52, Jace Russell, was the injured Husky.
and they do a quick toss to Braden Turner, who's got some room. He looks like he's going to have enough for the first down, and does. He got plenty more than he needed.
Gets him
all the way to the 41.
Makes the ball out to the 40-yard line.
Had an end around to the tight end. He rolls his way all the way to the first down. Gets 10 to pick up the first down.
Bryce Bender with the snap, looks to throw, throws to Pearson Baker, who is not paying attention, and it falls incomplete, and you can see Bryce Bender unhappy there. That brings up 2nd and 10, and you can see him barking at Pearson Baker for
that. Pass is incomplete.
Yeah, Pearson Baker was upset at himself about one. He knows he just missed that one, just couldn't get himself turned around in time.
The Huskies are looking at a 2nd and 10.
So it is Bender in the back again. Takes a snap, looks to pass again, throws it, and it is dropped incomplete. That'll be 3rd down
Bender
and 10.
Incomplete.
Two straight incompletions.
Out of the flat contender for number 3, Dev Matthews.
So Huskies.
3rd down.
Desperately trying to find some momentum in a 1st down. Everything seems to be going Mustang's way here in this first half. Score is 34-3, 1:18 to go in this first half. Bender takes a snap, does another option to Dev Matthews, who tries to get some room, but they bring him down after he gained 7 yards. To bring up,
Austin Pitts goes to number 3,
excuse me,
Dev Matthews.
8 yards. That'll bring up a 4th and 2.
And the Huskies, if they want a chance, they need to go for this. Not only go for it, but also convert it. Because if they cannot convert it, they cannot score before the end of the half. They need it.
It'll be 4th down.
So the clock moves under 1 minute. Score still is 34-3. Bender.
Another timeout's being used by Coach Whitson.
Play clock is now. Play clock is starting to wind down to 5 seconds. Bryce Bender's going to have to get the snap here quick. And a timeout will be called by Coach Whitson. We'll be back in a moment.
Huskies call timeout with 31 seconds to go in the first half.
Timeout with 31 seconds to go. It is 4th and 2, and the Huskies are going to go for it here. Bender in the back with 2 running backs to his right. Hands it off to Dev Matthews, who's going to get his 1st down and more. So the Huskies convert. 25 seconds. They're going to stop the clock to move the chains. The Huskies need to get in the no huddle here.
It'll be a 1st down for the Huskies.
20 seconds to go.
Clock is going to roll. I thought they called the timeout.
Bender takes a snap, looks to pass. He does. He's looking deep and a lot of contact.
Nothing called.
That is ridiculous. That should have been a pass interference.
As I said, we saw a lot of contact.
Caden Dickman.
Ball was thrown inside of Caden Dickman. Still a lot of contact. And no call by the back judge.
8 seconds to go. Huskies are going to look to just throw deep here for the end zone.
Yeah, they'll play three deep.
And Mustang sends a bunch of their players back. Bender looks to pass and is overthrown. That does give 3 seconds to go for this half, so they'll have time for one more play, and I'm assuming it'll just be a heave for the end zone.
Intended for number one, Jace Lakin. Third down.
Discussions being had. Last timeout called by the Huskies.
Timeout, Huskies.
Husky offense, Mustang playing five players way deep as they have one more play here with 3 seconds to go in the first half, and this will be just a heave for the end zone. Bender takes a snap, rushes forward. They're going to just do a quick throw over to Dev Matthews, who's got some room. Still trying to go, but brought down. That'll end the first half. Score is 34-3. Broncos do lead. Huskies will receive the second half kickoff when we come back. For now, it's halftime entertainment brought to you by the Edmond North Bands and Cheer and Palm doing a combined performance. We'll see you after halftime.
And now for your halftime entertainment. Your varsity cheer and pom team will perform a routine to showcase their seniors. These girls have dedicated countless hours of cheering on our Edmond North Huskies the past 4 years. Please give them a big round of applause as they perform for their last time tonight. We thank our seniors for all they have done and look forward to seeing where their future takes them. Ladies and gentlemen, the varsity cheer and pom team.
Thank you.
Another round of applause for the varsity cheer and palm team. Thank you, ladies. Now, at this time, please welcome the Edmond North High School Marching Band. The Edmond North Band Program is under the direction of Dr. Brad Coker, Michael Holliman, Aaron Epperly Reiswick, Ben Conrady, and Jolie Mills. Additional staff members are Kayla Gann, Trey Brabham, Ashley Holmes, and Thomas Peters. The band opened its 2023 competitive season at the UConn Invitational Marching Festival, at which they received the following honors. Outstanding visual performance. Outstanding music performance. Outstanding general effect. First place in finals competition. At the Mustang Marching Invitational, the band earned second place in their class and third place overall in finals. Their 2023 competitive marching show is entitled Out of These Safe Limbs and features the following music: Dance Monkey by Cones and I, original music by Michael Holliman, Promise Monkey by Dave Matthews Band, I Want to Be Like You from Disney's The Jungle Book. The band is under the field direction of drum majors Ryan Black, Damien Gow, Ben Kimbley, Damien Grove, Marilyn McNulty. Let's hear it for the Edmond North High School Marching Band.
Thank you. I do.
Let's switch the camera to real quick.
Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for the Husky Marching Band. The band concludes their competitive marching season tomorrow at 1:30 in Broken Arrow at the Oklahoma Bandmasters Association Class 6A State Marching Championship. We're proud of you. We wish you well, and good luck tomorrow. Weathers TV and Appliances Downtown Edmond is a proud supporter of Edmond Athletics. Come by and check out our newly renovated showroom or shop online at weatherstv.com. Shop local and go Huskies.
Never mistake, be smarter. Never position to win. Never position to go.
Welcome back to Husky Network. My name is Caden Rieger along with Devin Thompson. We are back here as the halftime kickoff is about to go. Scores 34-3, your Broncos lead. And the kick is up and deep, and it will fly through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Huskies will take over at the 20-yard line.
Ball will be placed on the 20.
Yeah, some special teams and issues for the Huskies. Luckily, they avoid anything like that being a possibility with the touchback. Down by 31. We are going to look to see if the Huskies can come out with some first half fire that they have had in previous games. this game, they come out obviously with zero energy, only put up 3 points compared to the Broncos' 34.
Price Bender in the shotgun. Do a quick pass to Jace Lakin, but they are calling a false start on the Huskies.
Yeah, not a great start.
Good ball, false start is called against the Huskies. 5 yard penalty, ball placed on the 15, still first down.
From the 15, we have a first down and 15.
And the refs are trying to reset the play clock here. It is Bender in the shotgun. Dev Matthews to his right. Takes a snap. Hands it off to Jace Lakin. Jace Lakin's trying to create some room, but is brought down behind the line. That'll bring up a second down.
Jet sweep, number one, Jace Lakin. Tackled by number eight, Johnson.
And a very cold night here.
Loss of two on the play. Second down.
Bryce Bender back in the shotgun again. It is second and long. Fires deep. And a diving catch! And it falls incomplete. And Pearson Baker, A for effort on that one, but it falls down incomplete.
It's a little slow to get up. We'll see number 11, Drake Spoon, swap with it.
For number 12, Pearson Baker.
Baker will come off, shaken up.
An incompletion will bring up third down and long.
And that'll bring up a third and long. Third and 17 to be exact. Takes a snap. Throws to Jace Lakin. Jace Lakin has some room.
And a lot of it.
And a lot of it. He's going to try and make it to the first down, and he will, in a massive gain.
Jace Lakin, number one.
Of about 18 yards on that play.
Yeah, great job by Jace Lakin. He takes the check
down.
Straight up the middle. Straight up the middle of the field. And he works around that Bronco defense to pick up a long first down. As I said, gain of 18.
First and 10, Bender in the back. With Dev Matthews, they hand it off. Dev Matthews has been held down to quite a few yards for his liking tonight against Mustang. They've done well to contain him.
Absolutely, and as I said earlier in the broadcast, that was definitely a main focus in practice this week. And concern for the Huskies is Dev Matthews comes off limping. But as I was trying to say,
down.
A huge focus in practice for the Broncos is containing Dev Matthews. Over 300 yards and 6 touchdowns against UConn. And he's been held to I believe he's over 60 now with that rush.
Bender drops back. He's going to throw deep. And whoa! And no, there's the flag. I was about to say, hit way early, Jace Lakin.
Pass intended for number one, Jace Lakin.
Flag did not come out for a second there.
The line judge on the Husky side is actually the one who threw it. That back judge did not.
They will call pass interference on the defense. That'll be 15 yards and an auto.
Pass interference is called.
First down for your Huskies.
Yeah, that one was blatantly obvious, and that back judge would have gotten an earful, including the line judge actually, would have gotten an earful from Coach Whitson.
Looked like the line judge was waiting for the back judge to throw, and he wasn't, so the line judge just took command and threw it himself.
Yeah.
For the Huskies. Ball's on the 46-yard line of Mustang.
Bender, two running backs to his right and left. Cal Reeder behind him, hands it off to Cal Reeder. Cal Reeder trying to find some room and is finally brought down, but he pushes the pile as far as he can to gain four, bringing up second and six. Huskies moving down the field. They still have a lot of ground to make up if they want to try and win this game, but they are going in the right direction.
And they will get into Bronco territory for the first time since the recent Manis field goal at the beginning of the second quarter.
And there's 9 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the third quarters. The second half is getting underway.
Conversation being had. They better hurry up as they aren't even set yet and only 4 seconds to go on the play clock.
Bender takes a snap. Hands it off to Dev Matthews, who's tracked down and brought down for a gain of nothing, and that'll be third down.
Matthews on the carry, number 91 Jones on the
and
tackle.
Dev Matthews is going to stay on the ground. This could be very bad for the Huskies.
He is very hurt, writhing in pain.
Official's timeout on the field.
And so we have an injury timeout. We'll see if Dev Matthews is will be good enough to come back into this game at some point, but we will take a timeout and we'll be back in a moment.
For the Huskies.
We have returned from Husky Stadium. Dev Matthews limped off the field with what appeared to be a leg injury, looks like an ankle. And Cal Reeder will take over running back duties, and he is rocked.
And they're thinking that it's fumbled, or at least a couple of the Mustang players, but it was not, and that brings up
Cal Reeder on
fourth down. And the Husky offense is going to have to stay on the field here as they are still going to try to win this game.
Former. No gain on the play. It'll be fourth and six.
Bryce Bender takes a snap, looks to throw, does. He's got Kane Dickman, and is almost intercepted, and the Huskies would have rather intercepted it.
Bender's pass is incomplete.
But it is a turnover on downs, and the Broncos will take over. Husky defense needs to make a stop quick here. And we'll see if they can do it.
always spotted at the Husky 42, at the Bronco 42-yard line.
Taking the snap, and timeout is called by the Broncos. We'll be back in a moment.
Broncos have called a timeout with 8:11 to go in the third quarter. Again, we'd like to thank some of our sponsors for supporting us. Country Financial, Nick McDaniel, Orthopedic Therapy Services, Weathers TV and Appliance, and Balanced Kitchen.
Welcome back after that timeout. Mustang takes a snap. They're going to hand it off and brought down. Not after he's gained 3 yards. Second and 7 will be the upcoming play.
Three-yard gain on the play. It'll be second and 7.
Mustang takes a snap, looks to throw, does. He's got an open man who will take it to the house. Touchdown, Broncos. They come out 5 minutes into this second half. Get back on the board. And as of right now, score is 40-3.
Yeah, as it stands right now, this game is just about over already. I mean, it's the third quarter, 7.5 minutes to go. Huskies down 40-3, and the Broncos look to make it 41-3, and they just have never really gotten a good drive together. They had one drive where they got to the 2-yard line, but they just could not punch it in. Once again, the penalties stacking up, getting stuffed at and behind the line. The only score for the Huskies, a Reese McManus field goal early in the second quarter. And here again, the offensive hardships showing early.
Number 23, Tatum Willis. Number 10, Dal Reeder.
Huskies tonight were unable to get anything really together. It would take an absolute miracle for them to win this game, which is not looking too likely as it stands right now.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, obviously, we hope that they can put something together, but as you said, unfortunately for the Huskies, it might be too little too late, even though we are only in the third quarter.
The kick is up, deep, over the heads, touchback.
Right over the head of Tatum Willis.
Ball goes out of the end zone, it'll be a touchback. North will have it on the 20-yard line. First and 10, Huskies.
Here come the Husky offense yet again. as we mentioned multiple times, they have not scored since early in the second quarter. Multiple offensive struggles with the turnovers, special team struggles with turnovers, really struggles with just getting the ball down the field.
Takes a snap, hands it off to Cal Reeder. He will gain three on the play to remain second and seven. And as I look at the bench, I'm not seeing Dev Matthews, so his night might be done after that ankle injury he had to be helped off the field with.
Yeah, it looked like while we were focusing on the defensive action, it looked like Dev Matthews did actually go back into the locker room. We'll keep you updated on his status.
And a deep throw to Caden Dickman almost brought in a lot of contact, but no penalty, and it'll be incomplete and bring up third and seven. So a struggle tonight for Bryce Bender, not really able to get his offense going. We'll see if he can string a couple of good plays together here to try at least get a touchdown in this game.
Yeah, a lot of no calls on the Mustang defense. They have been getting away with a lot. And we'll see just how far that will actually take them.
Bryce Bender looks to pass. Finds Pearson Baker for the catch, but taken out from underneath. Big hit. He will gain some, but it looks like they're going to send out the punt unit here with 6.5 minutes to go in the third. Score is 41-3 Broncos, and with that, might be checkmate here early in the second half.
Huskies are looking at a 4th and 4.
We have seen lots of aggressive play calls on 4th down in the past this season from Coach Woodson. Bender is back set to punt, but we could most definitely see a fake. And that's what we do. A quick pass to Cade Carbs. It is caught and a 1st down.
Cade Carbs goes down hard, but he does haul it in for a 1st down. Fake punt executed to perfection. As they were actually playing 3 out wide on both sides on that punt. So that left that middle of the field wide open. They send Cade Carbs up over the middle. And the only people left to cover him was that line and, well, the punt returner.
So it is Bender in the back again. Cal Reeder to his left takes a snap, hands it off to Cal Reeder, who tries to make some room. Gets brought down after a gain of 4, and it will be 2nd down.
We give the Reeder on the play.
With the offensive woes here early, I think that the Huskies should try to go to Cade Carbs in the backfield. We saw him make that big play on the punt return, or on the punt, fake punt, excuse me.
And
he had a big game against Owosso in the absence of Dev Matthews. Now in the absence of Dev Matthews yet again, it might be time to see him in the backfield yet again.
And a quick jet sweep to Pearson Baker, but Mustang was ready for it and push him out of bounds. He will gain 1.
Jet sweep, number 12, Pearson Baker.
And a flag is thrown. Some extra words being said between Mustang and North. We'll see what happens here.
It's like,
there is a flag on the play.
Don't know who this one will be going against. Sideline covering it. Sideline covering our view of it. We did see some pushing and shoving, so it might go on both teams. Pearson Baker seems to think that it is going to be against the Broncos. Unsportsmanlike conduct on the Broncos. Pearson
Baker
is
called on
right.
The Broncos and the Broncos only. That will get the Huskies 15 yards and an automatic 1st down.
We did see number 6 on the Broncos. A lot of words being exchanged, a lot of pushing and shoving.
A 15-yard penalty, an automatic 1st down, Huskies.
And that will actually put the Huskies into Mustang territory yet again.
So the Huskies trying to string together a couple plays to kind of bring that score up a little bit.
Yeah, if they can make this game even close, then that might light a fire under them that they desperately need. Three out wide, three out right, one out left.
Bender looks to pass. He's going to look deep for Caden Dickman. Almost intercepted.
Bender's pass is incomplete.
Great defense. Good defense by number five on Mustang. As it looks like the one who committed the unsportsmanlike conduct, number six, is going to take a seat for a couple of plays, possibly for the rest of this possession for the Huskies.
So it is Bender in the back again. Kyle Reeder to his right. Takes a snap, hands it off. Kyle Reeder's got some room, but brought down. He did gain a couple yards. That'll bring up a third down and about six.
And the kid Reeder goes off tackle, throws the ball to the 45-yard line. Tackle by number five, gain. Third and seven.
Third down and seven.
Bender in the back. Takes the snap. Looks to throw. Throws deep. He's got Jace Lakin. And it is intercepted. And a diving catch. Intercepted by the Broncos. Jace Lakin was open. But a quick cover by the safety gets the Broncos the interception. That'll be a turnover. And the Broncos will take over at about the 21-yard line in their own territory.
And we've said this a couple of times, but I believe that that one especially would be the nail in the coffin for the Huskies. And at this point, all they can do is try to prevent more scores and to help their point differential. Maybe put some scores up on the board just to try to, like I said, once again, help out their point differential.
And that's close to maybe their sixth turnover this game. Turnover is a big problem tonight for the Huskies.
Yeah, typically it will kill you in this game if you have more turnovers and the opposing team has penalties. And although all of those were not entirely the Huskies' fault.
They hand it off. He's trying to break some room. Gets brought down. Gains about seven on the play. It will be second
down. Seven-yard gain, second and three.
So fans have already made their way, started making their way to the exits. The crowd has thinned out here tonight as both probably the weather being as cold as it is and the score tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. Sub 50 degrees for the first time in these seasons.
And a Mustang player loses his helmet, so he'll have to go off for a play.
Oh, gosh, passes. Incomplete attempt for number two, Hayes. Number eight, Reese McManus on coverage.
That brings up third down and three. See if the Huskies can make a stop here. And it looks like that he made enough for the first down, and that will move the chains. First down, Broncos.
Broncos will have the ball on the 30-yard line. We'll have it first and 10. Number 11, Everhart on the carry. A pack of Huskies in on the tackle. Loss of one on the play, second and 11.
So it is a loss of one. It'll be second and 11.
Something to watch for is we may see number 15, David Lawler, come in for number 7, Price Bender, at quarterback. Huskies might be willing to make that change at quarterback for the rest of this game, simply to avoid any risk of injury to Price Bender.
We have this game pretty much out of reach. We still have a quarter to go, but it is 41-3.
Drop down by number 5.
You'll be watching the last score of action here on Husky Network, where Caden Rieger and Devin Thompson are still here
Keenan
calling
Moran
this game.
On that tackle. Third down.
And for those of you still watching, we'd like to thank you for watching and supporting our Huskies all season. As said before, I am Devin Thompson, here with Caden Rieger.
And a timeout is called by the Mustangs.
Broncos,
we'll be back in a moment after this break.
To go in the third quarter.
Back here after that timeout here on Husky Network. Looking to pass, does, throws deep,
and
has a man.
Wide open.
It is caught and making a run. Jumbles it a little bit, makes a move, goes around again, and will take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Mustang. So they add on more to their lead.
And as if it couldn't get any more out of reach.
And if the nail wasn't any more in the coffin, it is now.
That's absolutely right.
Gordon on the extra point try.
The kick is up.
The extra point is good.
Good. That'll make it 47-3, your score, as we get into the waning moments of the third quarter.
It's over. This is the second quarter.
Next week, Mustang will be hosting Edmond Memorial for their senior night. That could bring an intriguing matchup. So does Kyle Reeder and Tatum Willis back to receive this kickoff?
Willis and Reeder back deep for the Huskies. Jordan kicking off.
We have 51 seconds left in the third quarter, 48-3. after that long touchdown.
And the kick is deep, and that will go over their heads for a touchback out the back of the end zone. That'll start the Huskies off the 20-yard line, and it's still Price Bender at the helm. But we definitely could see David Lawler later in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. And I, honestly, as it should be, preserve the arm, preserve the body, really, of number 7, Price Bender. Has not had the best game today. So maybe for the rest of this game, it might be time to give him a seat. Just let him process this loss and just flush it. And we will see number 24, Cade Carbs, go into the backfield over number 10, Cal Reeder.
So that'll bring up a second down after a gain.
Number 24, Cade Carbs on the carry. It'll be 2nd and 7.
And now 20 seconds to go in this third quarter.
Huskies have no choice but to run one more play before the end. This quarter.
And they take the snap, hand it off to Cade Carbs again. He tries to break a tackle, does somehow get out of it, but he will still lose yards on the play. Now bring up a 3rd and 10 here as the third quarter ends. Score is 48-3. Broncos
Carbs,
lead. We'll be back here for the fourth quarter in a moment.
And that's the end of the third quarter. Starting long for the Huskies.
Huskies offense back out here after the break from the end of the third quarter. 3rd down and 10. Bender dropping back to pass. Threw a lot of contact. Pearson Baker.
Here the pass is incomplete, intended for number 12.
Now bring 4th down. Looks like they're bringing out the punt team. I don't think we'll see a fake here.
Yeah, I think we'll just see a regular punt here. Only the 2nd of the day through all of the offensive struggles for the Huskies. They've gone for it a lot of times, faked it. But only the 2nd actual punt, as long as this is an actual punt, of course.
It's a low snap, but it is punted, and it's going pretty far back, still bouncing inside the 10-yard line.
What a punt.
Down to the 5, and a beautiful punt from Price Bender across the entirety of the field.
Yeah, across the entirety of the field, as you mentioned. Punted from inside the 10, taking a bounce at about the 45-40 of the Broncos. 75-yard punt across the whole field, down at the 5-yard line. From inside 41 to go in the fourth. Oh, and
knocks down his own player on the design QB sneak. He does gain some yards, though. He'll gain about 8 on the play, and he'll spring up 2nd and 2, and that's something the Huskies have really struggled with this season is design QB sneaks here. As the fourth quarter begins, 11 minutes and 20 seconds to go here in this game. Broncos lead 48-3 against your Huskies.
Yeah, really the inside run in general the Huskies have struggled with, but of course more specifically the design QB runs. That is why you see a lot of the times opposing teams will just run it straight down the gut, because if they bounce to the outside, the Huskies are right there on them.
And it's another handoff. Forward progress will get him to the 24. Good enough for a first down.
Tackled by number 7, Johnson Cravens.
And at this break, we from Husky Network would like to thank all first responders, all firefighters, EMTs, police officers. Thank you for everything you do to make our city better.
And also a huge thank you to our Husky families, Husky seniors. Thank you for all of the support from you guys, all the memories from you Husky seniors.
The flag is thrown on the play.
Before I continue, we will check with the flag.
There's a flag on the play.
Conversations being had. So during the conversations, Caden and myself both being seniors, it has been a great season. With this Husky loss, this will most likely be the last time that you will be hearing from us from the home games. We will have at least one more Husky game, but that will be away against Union. And then given the playoffs, that will also most likely be an away game. So to all Husky families and all Husky seniors, thank you guys for all the support, all the memories, and it has been a pleasure.
And coming soon, your Husky basketball teams, both girls and boys, will be coming back, both looking for three-peats for state championships this year. And they could very well do it, as lots of returning players this season for your basketball teams. That's coming up soon, and don't worry, Dev and I will be covering some of those games.
Absolutely, as we get a stop in the back. Number 37, Jameson
McGee on the tackle.
Jameson McGee on that tackle. Second string senior.
Second and long for the Broncos.
They send two out to the right. As the Broncos leading by 45 with 9:30 to go. The one slammed down by Ricky Thomas. What a force he's been on that defensive line for the last 3 years. Won the starting job at nose tackle as a sophomore, and hasn't lost it since then.
Ricky Thomas, number 0 on the tackle. Third down
and 18.
Takes the handoff. Goes running. Definitely does not get the first down.
Yeah, he's short of it by about 15 yards. They will mark him down at the 19. Short. It'll be 4th and 15 for the Broncos. And here comes the punt unit for the first time tonight.
Down by number 0, Ricky Thomas.
And there's Pearson Baker back.
It'll be 4th down for
to receive. This punt,
and with the special
on a 4th
teams,
and long, deep in their own territory.
With the special teams' woes, they're just pretty much putting out anybody who could catch a ball out there, hoping that they can field the punt.
It's a high snap. Gets the punt away, and it'll land and bounce about to the 44-yard line, and that's where the Husky offense will take over. And it still will be
Bryce
Bender again.
Line.
coming back on the field trying to get at least a touchdown in this game. Broncos lead 48-3, 8 minutes to go in this fourth quarter. Huskies take over at the 43.
First and 10, Huskies.
Takes the snap, hands out to Kyle Reeder. Kyle Reeder tries to make a couple moves and finally gets pushed out of bounds. That looked like a late hit. But he does gain two on the play to bring up second and eight.
Now, long run for just a 2 yard gain, and we will get a penalty flag very late.
28 back is for the Broncos.
And this might be for that late hit that you mentioned on Kyle
Reeder. That would be quite the late penalty call.
Absolutely.
And they call an unsportsmanlike conduct on the Broncos. And that'll put 15 yards for the Huskies.
Yeah, unfortunately, that's a big penalty, but as we mentioned, this might be too little too late. Well, it will be too little too late, as even a touchdown would still be a 38-point deficit.
And an automatic first and 10.
It would take an absolute miracle for the Huskies to come back from this.
That's not looking very likely here, Deb.
No, absolutely not.
Bender in the back. Kyle Reeder to his left. He takes a snap. Hands it off. Reeder trying to find a hole, and it looked like he was grabbed from behind, but forward progress will give him 2 yards to bring up second and eight.
And for those of you wondering, number 3, Dev Matthews, is out for the rest of the night. We did get confirmation of that, as he has not returned to the sideline. He will get an early shower. Usually lackluster night from him.
Mustang came ready for him, that's for sure.
Yeah, Mustang definitely prepared heavily for Dev Matthews, and it paid off massively.
Hands off to Cade Carbs. Cade Carbs tries to find some room. Bulldozers through some defenders. A flag is thrown, but if it stands, it will look like it'll be a first down for your Huskies.
Looks like we might get a face mask penalty. I believe that's what I saw the ref signaling for, was a face mask on the Broncos. Personal foul for face mask.
That is
personal foul.
What the call is.
The Broncos.
That'll be a first down for the Huskies as they move down the field. Cade Carbs filling in for Dev Matthews, doing a pretty good job of it so far.
Absolutely, and that was what I was talking about earlier in the broadcast. They were running with Kyle Reeder, who's a great secondary back, a great change of pace from Dev Matthews. However, as your primary back, when you prepare for a runner like Dev Matthews, unfortunately, he's just not as effective.
Takes a snap, looks to throw. Throws for Pearson Baker, who tries to make the catch, and a lot of more contact, and a penalty flag is thrown, and we could see a pass interference call here, as there's a lot of contact.
Pass is intended for number 22, Pearson Baker.
If this is going to be a pass interference, that's only the second time the pass interference has been called.
Flag on the play.
And both of them coming from very, very late penalties. One of them almost not called by the back judge on a clear pass interference, and it is going to be pass interference on the Broncos.
And that moves the Huskies. Most of the Huskies' yards moving down the field with
the
penalty help
against the Broncos.
It'll be half distance to the goal, setting them up at the 8 yard line. Huskies looking to bite into this point differential.
It'll be first and goal, Huskies.
And help their crawl to the playoffs.
Takes a snap, hands it off to Cade Carbs. He's got some room. He barrels into the end zone. It's a Husky touchdown. So the Huskies get into the end zone at least one time tonight. That brings your score 48-9 without a PAT. And so Cade Carbs gets into the end zone for at least one touchdown here on senior night.
Yeah, and that's at least something. We get to see a senior score a touchdown on senior night. And who better
than
Kate Carbs? Earning his spot in the position of the injured Dev Matthews and has done a great job at filling that role. Even though he came into the game as the RB3.
We are halfway through this fourth quarter, 6 minutes and 22 seconds to go. Score is 48-10. So here comes his Husky kickoff team to kick it back to Mustang. Here with 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
McManus to kick it off for just the third time today.
Kicks it deep, and it's a kick that goes flying into the back of the end zone for a touchback.
McManus' kick goes into the end zone for a touchback. Broncos will have it first and 10 on the 20.
It off, has some room, but gets brought down by a pack of Huskies.
Brown on the
looks like 28 yard line in that pack.
Ball spotted at the 28 yard line, second and 2.
So this Mustang offense that's dominated all night long, looking to push this game towards an end as we're reaching 5.5 minutes to go in this fourth quarter. Takes a snap, design QB run, gets a first down and more down to the 40
yard line. Keeper, tackled by number 9. Preston McDaniel on the tackle. Balls on the 40-yard line. It'll move the chain.
And it's fumbled.
Yeah, it looks like
but recovered by the Mustangs.
The Broncos do recover it.
The Broncos will maintain possession.
But they will lose a lot. Looks like it'll be a loss of 8 or 9. Looks like it'll be a loss of 8.
Big loss on the play, second and long.
Second and 18 will be the distance.
Takes a snap, gets a couple of yards, and finally gets brought down at the 35-yard line.
Brown with the handoff up the middle.
4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter as we're getting near the end of this game. 48-10 is the score.
Tackled by number 26, Eric Taylor.
As we near the end of this game, we will say that the Broncos will head back home
to
face the Edmond Memorial Bulldogs for their final game of the regular season. Huskies traveling to Union to play the Redhawks. And for what will be their final game of the regular season and what could be a battle for the playoffs, depending on how the rest
of the quarterback keeper
the division shakes up.
Tackle by number 9, Preston McDaniel. Fourth and 9.
So it's fourth down, and they're just going to go ahead and keep the offense here on the field, it looks like. 3 minutes to go. We're getting into the waning moments of this game. And a false start is called against Mustang.
This is our false start is called against Mustang. It will be a 5-yard penalty. Fourth and 14.
We will see the offense stay on the field, it looks like. It looks like Mustang is trying to do whatever they can to run out the clock as we are under 3 minutes here. And I take that back. The punt team is coming out onto the field now. Punt is away, and it's a line drive punt.
It is finally picked up inside the 40. Looks to be at about the 34. 2.5 minutes to go, so this game is getting close to over.
And we might see one final push to the end zone by the Huskies just to cut this deficit down a little bit more. And with the second string defense out on the field, I would not be shocked if that is what we see. As Price Bender is going to come back out there, which is a little bit of a shock to me. Thought we would get to see our first look at number 15, David Lawler, sophomore quarterback.
Hands it off. Kyle Reeder's got some room. A flag is thrown. He'll gain a couple, but we await to see what the call is here.
There's a flag on the play. Cal Reeder on the carry.
He is holding against the Huskies. That'll push them back 10 yards.
Holding is the call.
Still 2 minutes to go.
The Huskies. Officials will mark it off and put it at the 24-yard line. Still second down.
So the Huskies come back to the line of scrimmage. Price Bender's still in the game. It is second and 20 after the holding call. Takes a snap, hands it off.
Go to Harris.
And he'll gain 2 yards on the play. It'll be a third and long.
Number 92. Coda
under
2 minutes
to go here.
Third down 19 for North.
With 90 seconds left to go.
Takes a snap. Looks to throw. Price Bender gets hit pretty hard, and it lays on him after the hit. Price Bender gets up. That'll be a fourth and very, very long, and I'm assuming the punt team will come out.
If I'm Coach Whitson here, I pulled Price Bender here just to conserve him in the game against Union. The last thing that they want to happen is him get injured in the late parts of this game, especially with next week being a must-win game if they want a chance at a home playoff game. Although maybe a home playoff game is not what they want, because the Huskies,
and they fake the punt
better on the road,
and they try to run it, and he gets
Walker
absolutely
Thompson
taken out.
Slam.
And all it'll take is one knee for Mustang here as the clock keeps ticking. It is now fourth down. There was no punt. Excuse us. Fourth down, clock ticks.
By number 40.
And it looks like we'll have one last play here in this game.
Ball's on the 26-yard line, fourth down.
Stay tuned in this one for one last post-game show from Husky Stadium of this 2023 season from myself and Caden Rieger.
And hands it off. And he finally gets brought down, and that will end the game here. Your final score, Mustang 48 and the Huskies 10.
Dakota Harris went down awkward. He's going to limp off.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give both teams a hand. Great job,
so,
gentlemen. You represent your schools well.
Struggles on special teams and offense, not being able to get much going.
Drive careful on your way home.
For the Huskies, leads to a loss here. And Mustang goes home after going on a four-game losing streak. Finally gets the win. And will go on to 5-4. And the Huskies fall to 3-6. Stay tuned for a quick post-game show from me and Devin.
I forgot I had that too. It's a busy weekend for me. Work tomorrow. All right.
Hello and welcome back. This is Caden Rieger along with Devin Thompson here. Huskies took a tough 48-10 loss tonight. Lots of struggles on special teams and offense, and some defensive struggles all just led to a loss. Dev, what was your quick take on it?
Well, honestly, they just could not get the offense rolling at any point in the game. A lot of times we've seen the offense come out and have a strong first half, and then they kind of die off at the end of the second half. But here, they just couldn't get an offensive drive going at all up until the end of the game, which is when all of the starters for Mustang got swapped out. So really, it seems like they were just underprepared for this game.
And the Huskies head to Union next week, hoping to secure their playoff berth. That's pretty much it from us. We thank everybody who's watched us this whole season. A big thanks to Mr. Campbell for us, our broadcasting teacher. He's been a big support for us and just the broadcasting class as a whole, so thank you to him. And we'll be back for basketball again, girls and boys both looking for their three-peats in state championships. We'll see if they can do it, where Dev and I will be covering a couple of the games, and we'll see y'all then. Thanks for watching.
Absolutely.